Hello everyone, so today I'm gonna do finally the video of the Bloodstalker. I know that a lot of people ask me for this, for month on month, so finally I'm gonna do it today. So, before, I hear a lot of people want to learn the Bloodstalker, but they instant want to kill everyone with it. It's not like this is gonna work. The first thing, for the Bloodstalker, you need to train to move with it, to be able to do from one point to another point easily without struggling. So first we're gonna talk about the stat. I would suggest for Bob to put full HP, doesn't care about the damage. You can have 1% damage, doesn't matter. You just put full HP on your PvP with other people. Like, you just acting like a super dino, like a Pteranodon. Pteranodon doesn't care about this damage, he just pick and bring to the gear, right? So when you starting the Bloodstalker, you should first learn to do that, to be the super dino. Then when you get a bit of experience, you can start to flex and kill people alone, but not at the beginning. So doesn't matter the damage in the beginning, just put full HP for survive the wave of dino you're gonna meet in PvP. Then we're gonna talk how to move with it. So it's pretty simple when is no rock, no foundation. You can sprint of course, shift, left, right, whatever. If we come here, where is foundation, and I ask you to sprint, you will certainly get glitch. Sometime. It depends. Ah, by example like this. Yeah, it's worse with the lag. So some people asking me how I run so fast on the foundation without getting climbing. Because when you shift, you climb at the same time. So you will climb every foundation you're gonna meet. So what I use is two solutions for that. First, for stopping the climb, you press X. That's the best thing. But if you want to be faster, you just press space while you're sprinting. And then you can run over foundation without climbing. Pretty easily. Second solution. You can press C. Spamming C attack. And it will cancel the climbing all time. I prefer using space, but if I'm chasing someone at ground, I will press C. I will just put a macro pressing C and I will run fast and at the same time I can hit him doing damage, killing. Okay, the next step is a jump. So, it's two kind of jump. The little one, that you just press space. Double jump. You cannot make triple, it's double max. Then you have the big jump. You just press space long time. If you press long time and go forward at the same time, you will make this strange move really cool. You can do it from the side also. You can jump back. So now the key that you're gonna use a lot in Bloodstalker, it's control. Control, it's making a little parachute, I don't know what to say, you're planing in the sky. It means you can stay here forever like this. Till you have stamina, you can jump, spamming jump, and stay like this. is really useful because spider in the ground is a spider death. You don't want to stay ground in PvP. You prefer to be climbing something or in the sky. Whatever, all time you need high ground. So when you have understand all the little basic stuff, you should do the mission. This one. Which one? You need to do this mission, like over and over, till you get the alpha. When you validate the alpha, you can start PvP with it. I mean, it's no point to use a spider and just staying in the cliff platform and just waiting for someone. Spider have to move. Spider is already mobile. If you don't know how to move it, you don't know how to use spider. So, when you get this mission validated, you have the basic movement of the Bloodstalker. Okay, something you need to know. What is that? Please. Okay. Something you need to know. If your Bloodstalker getting low life under 40%, I think, she's gonna start to eat you. I'm gonna show you. More the spider of damage, more it's gonna eat you fast. It destroys the flak and destroy your health. So when you have 25k HP at the end, you have not 20k, 25k, you have less than 15k. You know that Bloodstalker is angry when she's starting to down things like this. If you hide at this moment, I will certainly die. Let's see. So yeah, it's destroying me pretty fast. So imagine you're getting low life in the middle of the fight, you're pretty dead. Well, the best way to dodge that is to have the blood pack on you, and the spider will take the blood and not kill you, but she needs a lot of blood pack. So if you have someone that doing blood pack in your tribe, is pretty good. Me personally, I never have because I'm lazy to doing it. Well, now I'm think you are ready to jump and to use your left and right click. I'm gonna explain you how that works. So left click is just one tentacle and right click is the second one. Or two at the same time if you right click first. For example here, I'm gonna right click. Left click, only one. Most of the time you're gonna use right click. It's more fast and you have more snap point with the rock, and the mountain, tree, whatever. How to use left click for grab enemy? Well, one is white, it means it's too far. Red, it's the range. White, red, it's easy. So when you have a target red, you just grab, it will make a big green around him, it means he's snapped to your grapple. You can pull him, and then you just get. You can do that manually, or you can let the dino doing himself. For example, what I'm gonna do is Spionics here. Hop, I grab him, I unhide. And the dino gonna do it alone, even in passive. And you can do something else. C attack do way more damage than the grab attack, but The problem is when you see attack someone, he can plant the U or counter attack with something else. When he's in your mount, he can't do anything. He can just punch or try to escaping. So depending on the situation, you're gonna use one of those. So now I'm gonna explain you how to climb the rock. If you climb from the front, you cannot. Even if you're pressing shift, you cannot. It's only from the side. From the side, it's working. Then you can stop pressing shift and you can go up. Shift is just gonna go faster. So if you watch my video, I'm always climbing something and grab from this kind of position like this. Because the problem when you're at the ground, you can miss. You can miss the target if you aim bad. But if you're climbing something, yeah, you can't miss because the left click will not. You don't gonna grab anything till you grab a target. See? You can literally spam click. Press X for stopping the grab. So now I will show you how to climb without starting from the bottom of the structure. Like climb from midair for example. So you can jump, make a big jump. Oh my god, fuck you! You can jump forward and press space, you keep space and you're gonna snap the rock. This, or you can left click, space, you keep space, you keep pressing space. You can stop after you are sure to be climbing the rock. Right click, it's work also. Sometimes with the lag, you're gonna just jump. But if it's not laggy, the server it will work really fine. Now I'm gonna show you how works the Bloodsucker in the water. So, as you can see, you cannot grab, cannot climb anything in the water. The only thing you can do is press C. You can sprint. When you press C, you go down faster. You press space. You go up. If you just press X, it go up also. Shift at same time and go faster. So when you press X, you're going above the water. X again, underwater. So we're gonna focus above water because it's what interesting us. What is interesting the water if it's the same that when you climbing something. When you climbing a rock, you cannot left click. You see, I cannot left click anything. It means I can grab shit pretty easily without missing. So when you are in the water, just above the water, sorry. You can just left click and get pretty easily a target because you can't miss. I mean, if you miss, okay, you have to have nothing around you. If you have a rock or something, you're gonna climb, you're gonna grab it. But for example, if I go in the middle of this water here, I'm too far from anything and I cannot miss anything because the grapple will not go out till I get a target. Yeah. I can left click spamming, nothing gonna happen until I get a target. So when you want to fight a Bloodstalker enemy, the best thing to do in the water is to have the structure behind you. Because if I see a spider in front of me, for example here, I will just grab the rock all the time. Spiders are really hard to grab in the water. You're gonna just try to grab the spider and me and just do that. But if you are in the opposite side, the guy here, he cannot miss you. You just have to spam click till he gets you. That's why when I'm fighting in the water, you're gonna always see me in this kind of position, like this. And not in the opposite side. I never fight a spider in this side. It's like suicide. The biggest counter of the Bloodstalker is the mana. So when you see a mana rune, just don't land at ground. It's death. If you see in this video, I'm gonna never touch the ground. Never, never. Look, even when I'm in the sky, they try to focus on me because they know they can literally one-shot me. So what I'm doing, I'm climbing, climbing, climbing on the right opportunity to kill one. When I'm climbing, it's pretty easy to grab someone. Gonna see if I climb. This one is coming. What I'm doing, instantly grappling him. He can't do shit. In this kind of position, he's dead. He's dead, and you know it. Well, this tutorial was really basic. Nothing special. It maybe it helps some noobs that want to start the Bloodstalker. I don't gonna give all my tips because I don't want to get other Bloodstalker gonna use against me. Okay, the video is over now. Thank you to have watched. If you want more videos of this kind, another guide, just tell me in the comment and don't forget to subscribe, okay? See you.